funniest comedians making his mark as one half of the hilarious comedy duo Leno and Woodley. But Frank Woodley has made a successful solo career and now he's getting kids giggling with a show just for them. Please welcome to Studio 10, Frank Woodley!
I love an enthusiast, and you've got a room full of them.
You came in with almost a Tony Barber run.
He's my role model, my inspiration, Tony.
Well, yeah. So much of your comedy as well is physical, right? So does that make the transition from adults to kids a little bit easier?
Possibly, but I found it was amazing doing the kids show because it's the first kids show that I've done, and I was really scared that maybe I wouldn't be able to connect with them for some reason, that they would have, you know, that it would be different. And I found that as long as the content, as long as they understand what I'm talking about. So I do a story about a horrific show and tell experience I had in primary school, or being bullied at school and how I overcame these two bullies. And so as
how
long
did
as
you do that?
How did I overcome it? Yeah. Well, it's not one of those things where it's going to be educational for people at home, because I overcame it by, and it's based on a sort of a true story. One of these bullies was, so this is not something you can try at home. There was, she was going to fight me, and there was a ring, it's a big girl. There
is
was
that
a ring.
She?
Of,
oh.
Yeah. How sexist to think even all sexes can be bullied.
Yeah.
But no, because often
so
in primary school particularly the
you.
Girls
yeah.
are much
yes,
bigger. But and there was a ring of kids around us going, you know, fight, 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 fight. And I tried to get them to change it to discussion. They wouldn't go for it.
I like
and,
that idea.
And I was trying to get out through the kids, and as I was pushing through the kids, I went like that. And I heard the girl, you're laughing now, but it gets full on. Okay, but I heard the girl behind, and this is why the show is kind of for 8+, because it does get a bit, you know, intense. Ooh. I heard the bully behind me going, which I wasn't really expecting, and you weren't either, Sarah.
No, it wasn't at all.
And what had happened was, as she touched my shoulder, I'd gone like that, not even meaning to, and I'd punched her under the jaw,
ooh,
and she'd bitten the end of her tongue off.
Oh!
Because she'd, yeah.
Wow.
So that's how I overcame that bully, by making her bite her tongue off. So it's not really a strategy that we can get all kids. So try that, kids. Get your bully to bite their tongue off.
That's good conflict resolution.
I think you should roll
that out in schools everywhere.
You need the planets to align in a horrific, sort of accidentally violent way.
You're a fantastic comedian, one of the best we've had here. Do you have to change a lot of your material for the kids?
What I found was I had to completely change the material, actually. That the material, but not the style.
Ah, yeah.
So
because
the content,
I love your style.
I just do it exactly the same way that I would do. Yeah. And there's a few things, actually. Like, for example, I do this thing where I've got a... It depends. This joke is a seasonal joke, so I can't do it at the Opera House at the moment. But I have a mango pip that I'm sucking on when I come onto stage because I just love mangoes. Mm. And then I realise, oh, this is ridiculous. I shouldn't be sucking a mango during the whole show. That's not very professional. So I'll just chuck that in the bin and I go over to the bin and I grab it and I just squeeze it and it pops out of my hand like the, you know, the soap... kind of thing. And then I spend, you know, the next sort of 5 minutes picking up the mango pip and trying to get it into the...
So there's a silliness
the bin.
To your comedy,
and I did that routine to adults because I just think it's a fun thing.
Yeah.
And it was a bit, that's right. But when I do it for the kids, they love it. And so I'm sort of like, yeah, you're my people. Finally, I've found some people who understand me, you know, so it's great.
I would imagine kids would be a tougher audience than adults, because at least adults will laugh to be polite. They know what's sort of expected by them.
Yeah.
Kids do not give up.
Yeah,
does that scare you?
That's true. It did scare me initially, but it turned out that they're just actually very enthusiastic and warm, and they've been really enjoying the show. And so I've been thinking, why haven't I been doing this for years, you know?
Do you have child hecklers?
You do. You don't have hecklers so much as there will be kids who will... say, yeah, I thought that was scary, or something. Just kind of agree, almost more agree with you or say yeah. their opinion. Or like suddenly some kid will go, oh, I've got a cat, you know. And it's
not even, I love that child. I've got three cats. I've got three, man.
My 3.5-year-old son heckles me all the time and he says, you know, well, you're a poo-poo. And I've got no comeback for that.
No,
yeah, that is harsh. Like, and I have to agree with him. Unanimous.
You are fantastic, Frank. Yeah. Thank you so much for being with us this morning. And you can check out Frank's new show, Frank Woodley, Noodlenut, in the Playhouse, at the Playhouse of Sydney Opera House. It's on from the 25th of September right through to October 8th. You can head to sydneyoperahouse.com to grab your tickets. Frank, thanks again. Thank you.